What's up, guys? I'm DeckaCrafter, and today I'm going to show you how to set up a CrazyCraft upgraded premium server for you and your friends. The reason we're using a premium server is because hosting it yourself isn't too ideal, considering you need about 8 gigs of RAM, which means the servers actually are typically fairly expensive. In fact, I'll show you if we exit and go to multiplayer and then need a server. Let's say we just want 4 friends on it, and we're using this mod pack. If we go with the budget plan, literally the cheaper option, it's going to cost us $24 a month. That's insane. So, I'm actually going to show you how you can get it down to $10 a month, and we're not using Bisect. Sorry, Bisect. And we're still getting an 8 gig server. I'm telling you up front now, the price is only 10 bucks. Now I'm going to walk you through setting it up A to Z so that you're ready for you and your friends to join and start playing in just a few minutes. First, of course, to even play CrazyCraft Updated, you're going to need CurseForge. If you don't have it, I'm going to have a link in the description for you. Just go down there, install CurseForge, and when you're at the home, you can go to like Minecraft Mod Packs, Browse Mod Packs, type in Crazy, hit Enter, boom, CrazyCraft Updated. Just hit Install on it, and then once you've done that, go to My Mod Packs, and then hit Play on it. Now, since we don't want to rent a server from them because it's so expensive, we're actually going to use a host that I've used forever who has quick setup for this mod pack. The host is Shockbite. If you want to use my affiliate link, that's going to be down in the description as well. So if you want the greedy server host to get less money and you want to help out my channel for showing you this cheap option, please use my link. And anyway, let's go down here. We're going to see the Emerald plan, $8, and it's actually still cheaper without any sort of discount, 20 bucks. Make sure you have the monthly option selected, or if you want to spend more and save, so take the price that you see here, you're going to save 50%. So if you want it for a whole year for 90 bucks, it's not too bad, but most of us probably aren't here to spend $90. Server location, I always put my preference for North America. Big heads in the way. No dedicated IP because that costs extra and you don't need it, it's just you and your friends. And no server management, we don't need the server management either. That just costs extra for no reason. I'm your server manager. I got you. Hit continue. 8 gigs, quantity 1, 20 bucks. We're not even going to use my DeckaCrafter discount code. We're going to use this one here, Experience 2019. You see that? Experience 2019. Or you can use my code, but honestly, all that matters is that you use my link if you want to support me. You don't have to use my code. But you just hit validate code. And for whatever reason, since 2019, this code has always worked. And now, we can hit checkout, and it's only going to be 10 bucks. Alright, once you've ordered your server, you can go to the client area of Shockbite. If you're on Shockbite's website, it's going to be right here in the top right. Just click that. It'll be here. You're going to click services. Go to my services. And of course, I use them a lot, but the server we just got is this 8 gig server here, so I'm going to click on that. Now obviously I'm going to blur my personal information, but what you're going to want to do is at the bottom here you'll see go to Multicraft. You're going to use your login information that you had set up when purchasing the server. Then you'll see a list of servers. I named mine DeckaCrafter's server and you'll see it as offline. Then you'll see some basic things you can change if you want to. But what we want to do is go down here to server type. We're going to type in crazy, and then you'll see CrazyCraft Updated 1.16.5. Click on that and hit save. After you've hit save, we're actually going to go over here to where it says files above my head, up here. And under the files category, you're going to click setup right here. Once you're there, we're actually just going to click here and scroll down until you see where it says mod packs. And then right here, because they're alphabetical, we'll see mod pack, CrazyCraft Updated 1.16.5099. Make sure these boxes are not checked and hit apply. Then once it's saved, you can go back to, if you click here, DeckaCrafter's Minecraft server. Alright, then what you want to do is hit stop, and then hit start. To make sure it's doing what it's supposed to do, go to console, and you'll see it's setting up the CrazyCraft server here. This is also where you can op yourself and stuff, so you can type directly into here. So if I want to, I can type OP DeckaCrafter. I wouldn't do this until after the server is loaded up, but then you will op yourself and you can use commands in-game. That is going to take a while for it to set up. Okay, so once you see that it's preparing spawn, that means it's almost done. I would say it takes about 5-8 minutes. Alright, it finished preparing spawn, so the server is going to be ready. Sometimes it will look like it's frozen, it'll stop saying things. Just let it load, don't touch your server. I promise it's going to work. So then what you want to do is go to multiplayer in your game. We're going to go back here to the server. We're going to copy this IP right here under server address. So multiplayer, add server, paste it in here, you can name it whatever you want, hit done. And now you have a server for you and your friends to play CrazyCraft Updated. I hope this video helped you guys out. And real quick, if your game's lagging, or you keep crashing or something, you might just need to update your profile in CurseForge. Go to the settings in here, then click on Minecraft at the bottom here, and then you'll see if you scroll down, Java settings. You can change the amount of RAM you have dedicated. If you don't know how much RAM your PC has, just right-click your little Windows icon here and click Setting or System, and then you'll see how much RAM you have. Don't use all of your RAM, save at least 2 gigs. But anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed the tutorial, and I'll see you in the next one.